9/11 happened, Rashid al-Nazaili felt that the honeymoon for the Arab American community was over. The world had changed. After he started to hear some discussions around the Arab American community, that there were many Arab countries and there were divisions between them in the local media, insinuating the people who were responsible for 9/11 were from only one country, Yemen. So to prove that was not the right way to think, he had to do something about it. In 2005, Rashid started to write articles in Arabic for some news websites in Yemen as a hobby. Rashid later talked with his best friend, Muhammad Adais, about publishing a newspaper, and Mr. Adais suggested building a website first, which launched on November 2007. Then 7 months later, the Yemeni American News was born as a monthly newspaper with online video clips.
The Yemeni American News. More than a newspaper. More than a website. More than an organization. More for the community.
It was time in 2008, and even probably we were a little bit late to produce such a newspaper that tells our stories, because we have to tell our own narrative and not let others write our narrative.
In 2011, the Yemeni American News produced a documentary movie about the Yemeni community and how it contributed to and had value in American society.
I was born in a small village called Irim, which is in the southern part of what used to be the Kingdom of Yemen.
That move put them on the map as a respected organization moving forward with limited resources and much passion. 3 years ago, Rashid became good friends with the new editorial manager, Yasser al-Arami. He brought some new ideas to improve the paper, changing the size, a new graphic design, expanded reports with a new focus on building and supporting a new team based in Yemen. The paper has steadily increased page by page up to 40 pages in each monthly edition. The Yemeni American News today has 10 employees, 5 of them from Yemen. With every new ad, they hire a new person in Yemen, and their dream is to have 50 more from Yemen. Especially in these days when there are no salaried jobs in Yemen during this tragic and unfair war.
It does actually shed lights on a lot of issues that concern our communities, particularly the youth, and try to shed lights on positive aspect. And it's our memory as a community. So it write our own stories. We need to write our own stories. We can't afford to have other people write our own stories. So it's a good platform for young men and young women, particularly the new generation. They can go on and contribute and write articles and publish stories. And it's a good resource.
Rashid asked me if I want to design the newspaper at the time. So I looked at the current issue and I said, this sounds interesting. And we went from there. I enjoyed working with the team, especially telling stories that you can't find anywhere else, that you will only find in the Yemeni American News.
I think one of the advantages of Yemeni American News is its objectivity to so many controversial issues and topics. Yemeni American News still manages to present everything with a very objective lens.
This particular media was different from the very beginning in the focus in putting the Yemeni American community in focus, in the simplest thing that goes in the community to the biggest thing that goes in the community. And that focus we have not seen in other publications.
We had already developed this really wonderful, mutually beneficial relationship, not only between Rashid and I as friends, but between the museum and the Yemeni American News as institutions that both support the community. And so since then, I like to say that the relationship has really blossomed quite a bit. Rashid and the newspaper have held events here. He's frequently here, regularly here. And he is a great ambassador for the museum as well as for the Yemeni American community through the newspaper, through the example that he sets as an individual, as a father, a husband, a businessman, a student. It amazes me how much he's been able to accomplish in this 10-year period with all of these various demands pulling on him.
It's information. It's almost like a history book that is not covered anywhere else. What's going on in Yemen and in the Middle East, whether I don't see it in the Main Street media, in the Detroit News, Detroit Free Press, or on the television networks, but I see it in the Yemeni news. And otherwise, I don't think I would know half the things I know about Yemen. So I'm very appreciative of it. It's a living history book.
When this started 10 years ago, it was really basics. But you see it now, it really compete with very close to Detroit News, comparing to the Arab American community. And it's really outstanding, cover variety, they're not biased. They really interview dominant figure in the country, business people, and put emphasis on the Jalia or the community, how they succeed in America. The future is open, leave the door open for more progress and prosperity.
The focus is not to have a news, because the news is everywhere, but to have a story. Story of the Yemeni American community, the suffrage of the Yemeni American community, the success of the Yemeni American community. That's how we become a resource. And I can tell you from my experience from that time until now that I'm very proud of the work you're doing.
Oh, I pick the paper all the time. I get it all the time. I go to El Kebab or different restaurants, always get the paper. Yeah, that's how I found out about it. And I found that I was glad. I wish it would come out more often. It helps keep me in touch with the community. The young Muslims need to see others doing things here in this country. They need to know that you can be in America and you can live in this system and succeed as a Muslim. That there's freedom here in this country that we can take advantage of and use it to our advantage and to advantage of this country. Because they need the thinking, they need our minds. This country needs our input in order for it to survive, in order for it to succeed and keep going further. It needs good minds, good people, good morals, and good heart. And that's what I want the young Muslims to see.
Dr. and PhD Abdul Wahab Al-Makaleh has been working with the paper as translation consultant. He said, the Yemeni American News is successful in many ways, especially in the area of bridging the cultural gap between Yemen and the U.S., connecting Yemeni Americans with their homeland. The Yemeni American News, in its rich content, brings unique content that readers enjoy and learn more about contemporary issues in their respective communities. The Yemeni American News follows Yemeni Americans, their issues, and presents their success stories and experiences to the reader in a profound way. Through its content and coverage, it inspires others to follow the presented role models. As a professor at Sana'a University, I present many of the Yemeni American News stories as part of the course curriculum for translation and reporting assignments. I hope through the newspaper, students will improve their language and writing skills. In addition, I hope they do get inspired by the presented success stories.
Newspapers are so vital to our democracy. The spreading of accurate information matters so much. And if you're targeting a specific community, Yemeni Americans, then that's wonderful, because maybe they'll be more apt to read the Yemeni American News than they will be to read the Detroit News. At least they're getting good information, accurate information, well presented. I think that the writing is good, the story selection is good. It's also like a monthly magazine, good, informative, in-depth features, the kind of stuff that you can't just get in 6 inches of type in a story.
Thinking back on the movie we did quite a while ago called The Yemeni Voices in America, it was a very good project. I think the main thing I really appreciated about that project was the featured story. Dr. Rashid Abdu was amazing. Just, he's so charismatic. He has a good story. He's got a beautiful heart, a beautiful spirit. So I enjoyed interviewing him and following him around at the hospital, his home, his friends, And you could just see him bringing light to all the people around him. And when he spoke about his wife and his friends, sometimes tears of sincerity would come to his eyes.
And I was a little nervous. It was my first time being interviewed by anyone from the media, and I was made very comfortable immediately. I was treated very graciously. I certainly appreciate that. And once the interview was over and I saw the video and I saw the article, then I knew that you were a stand-up guy, that it was a stand-up paper, and that everything that I had talked about that was important was included.
It was a great feeling to have when people read your content and they give you feedback or they ask you questions, and some are not happy with if you write an opinion piece of what you wrote, or some are, give you more ideas on what to write next. If you're not hearing much, then that means you're not doing your job. I feel like when you create a conversation and that conversation then becomes a bigger conversation and then actions perhaps may come out of it, that's when you're actually doing your job as a journalist, as somebody who writes.
We share the desire to tell accurate, compelling stories. And so when Rashid has held events here, it's reflected well on the museum. The museum reflects well on him because he is here and he is a part of the institution. Having that relationship, I think, has been, I can't think of another community leader that has been personally so hands-on, so present. We have many wonderful leaders who support the museum, and this is not to denigrate them, but Rashid is there all the time. He is with us.
As a historian, it's very important for me that the community has a record, that years from now we can go back to it to see what were the issues, what was happening in the community, to see the growth of the community. And since the American News has already been around for 10 years, I think it is a paper of record for the community, and I'm really excited that it's here and it will continue to thrive, so that we always know what happened here nationwide with the Yemeni community and the Arab American community and their connections to Yemen. And sometimes it's about heart as much as it is about trying to get the story. And I think if you really care about the people that you're talking about and you're really trying to give information that is useful to the community from the perspective of people that are in the community, I think it's it's a different kind of news, and I think it can be much more valuable.
Where I was in Kansas City, I didn't really know any Yemeni Americans. And so I got on the internet and I did a kind of a Google search and found out that there was this great resource called the Yemeni American News. And so fortunately there was an email address there, or I sent this email to Rashid, who at the time obviously I didn't know. And I was telling all about my experience, how I lived in Ba'dan in Lu'ib, how I was a teacher there, talked about the village that I was in, Al Shayt Al Dais School, and sent that off to Rashid. The next day, I get a phone call from Rashid, and he said, "Is this Kip?" And I said, "Yeah, this is Kip." He said, "You know, this is really, really unusual. You know, I read your email and I thought you were a crazy man, because nobody spends time where you did in Yemen." And he said, "You know, the interesting thing is one of my best friends was from your village." And he said, I asked him, "Do you know a teacher, American teacher that was in your village?" He goes, "Usted Kip?" And right then he knew that I was authentic.
One thing I've noticed about your paper is that you're always fair, impartial, and you're always timely. You seek out the best information that the community needs to know, and you do it in a very objective manner. And at times your paper is even entertaining for our community, so we like that aspect of it.
I know about the paper because I eat a lot of Yemeni food. And so, you know, this is at a lot of the different storefronts, and so that's how I found out about it. And then if you're waiting for food, you usually want something to read, and so that's what I do, is I pick up the paper and I read. As a public relations professional, I can tell you the biggest thing for me is recognizing when a media outlet is fair and when it's not, right? When you're going to get a fair shake and when you won't. I'd implore you, you know, just keep going with where you've been in terms of having your even-handed reporting. because it's so needed in our community.
And especially I had a lot of interest in reading it last year during the campaign for the mayor, and I believe you had a big interview with the mayor last year. I do follow your newspaper because I want to know what are the issues that concern the Yemeni American community.
Once I became aware of the paper, then I started seeing that you guys were doing actual reporting. That's what I really like about the paper now. You're covering issues that I think really matter to the Yemeni community. I mean, as the community grows and professionalizes, your paper is doing the same thing. And they're giving you a lot of really good material to cover because the community is doing so well right now. You maybe do some more expose stories on what it's like to be a Yemeni in this political climate with the travel ban, with the war on terror, with the suspicion the community faces. I think I would love to see more stories like that. You've come to really be a source of news and information about the community that people need and rely on. So because you've become that essential thing, right? I see a period of growth and inshallah success.
One example of the impact the paper is having in Yemen is through our graphic designer, Zakaria Al-Hakami. He creates the designs you see at your newsstand from halfway across the world. As he says in his own words, "I began working for the Yemeni American News during the most intensive bombing of Yemen in 2015. I received a call from my dear friend, editor Yasser Al-Arami, asking me to work on a new logo and a new look and feel for the newspaper. I immediately began to do the necessary work to show them my talents. My excitement was met with the realization of the difficulty of the challenge, not just to do my job, but to do it without electricity or internet, while the bombs are falling on the city. I got used to working in the dark, literally. I used to work on more than one laptop to take advantage of their battery life, moving my files back and forth. I had to run the generator late at night, disturbing my neighbors. Time was precious. Every minute counted. The first deadline felt like I was in a horror movie. When the laptop battery died, I went out in the morning to my neighbor's to borrow his generator. As soon as I got to the generator, the entire internet connection just vanished in my area. I told the editor that I had to move to another location, hoping to find an internet hotspot. Most internet shops had closed their doors because of the war and the blockade. I finally found a friend who had an internet cafe with a connection, possibly the last in Yemen. I quickly drove down to his cafe, uploaded the large files, and informed the team. I always feared for my life and my loved ones. The thought of an airstrike hitting my building was not unwarranted. This type of work requires cool nerves and a quiet environment. It was terribly difficult to focus, but I was determined to put forward my best work. Despite the hardships, it has been a rewarding experience. I love my work for the Yemeni American News, and I find it enjoyable."
Actually, when I gave up on the designing duties, and we actually hired a professional graphic designer from Yemen to do the newspaper, we elevated the look and feel of the newspaper and gave it a new look. And I believe that was a great jump for us to rely solely on professional graphic design and making it look nice. And also the focus more on how do we produce a story and make it so good. So we go through a lot of revisions from proofreading it to getting other people to look at it before it's being published to sending it to if it's being translated and if it's being published in both languages.
There are stories that come from Yemen that are amazing and they're different. And so Yemenis need to tell their own stories, but my community, we also need to hear them. So that's why I really think it's important you have an Arabic side of the newspaper, you have an English side, because the broader community needs to understand more about Yemen and the Yemeni people and how important and valuable contributions they make to society. And part of my heart is knowing that the paper is providing some value and jobs and resources back in Yemen. I think that's important. We can't forget where we came from, where the Yemeni community is from. And so if this paper, this enterprise, this project can provide value and jobs and some sustainability back in Yemen, it's very, very important. And that's partly why I feel strongly that I want to continue to be involved.
The Yemeni American community needs a voice. I think that we have to have some independent journalism in this city from all walks of life and all perspectives. And it is extremely important that we have someone who is a voice for the Yemeni American population in Dearborn. It's very large and very important to our community.
I believe the Yemeni American News connects both Yemen and America, and not only tells the stories of Yemeni Americans here and their aspirations and their goals, but also we've been telling stories also from Yemen, especially ever since the 2011 conflict. Yemen had become kind of the forgotten story of the world, that you have very little coverage on what's happening over there. And we try to focus more on the humanitarian side, on the real life experiences of the people who are struggling over there, rather than the political news that we hear all the time, pretty much on a daily basis.
Be able to have a newspaper that deals with the community like it does in such detail, and you know, a lot of papers come and go, but the fact that the Yemeni American News has been around for 10 years is really, really amazing. You know, I really, really enjoy it, and you know, being first in Kansas City and now in Chicago, I'm able to pull that paper up and really get a good idea about what's going on with the Yemeni American community, what's going on with Yemen, which I consider kind of my second home.
يا سكن مع البذور الزاهية.